Hi students, today we are doing lesson 8.2, adding polynomials. This is basically the same thing as adding like terms, so this should not be hard at all for y'all. I think that we will be getting into subtracting polynomials next, so that one has a little bit more mistakes in it. But this one is basically adding like terms, and so it's super easy. So we're going to do 5 examples today, and I'm probably going to ask y'all to do the last 4 on your own. So let's just do the first one together. Okay, this says add 3a plus 2b minus 8c plus 8. Okay, and then we're going to add to that 2a minus 4b plus 6c plus 9. So go ahead and get that written down. And I'm going to put a line under it. And notice that everything that's lined up is already like terms. So these are all the A's, these are B's and C's. And then these are your constants, or the ones without variables. So when I add these up, I'm going to get 5A minus 2B minus 2C plus 17. And that's my answer. See how easy that was? Okay, example 2, I'm going to show you the same idea, but it's going to look a little bit different. So sometimes in your book, although there's not too many like this today, it will say add, and then it will give you things like maybe in parentheses. It might put some things separated by commas. But the first one is 2x squared plus 3xy plus 5y squared. And then they put a comma because they're saying add that to this next one, which is 8x squared minus 5xy plus 3y. And then the last one they want you to add to it is x squared plus 2y squared. Okay, so I was going to have you do this one by yourself, but let me show you what you're supposed to do. So it's telling you to add all 3 of these parentheses together. So what you're going to do is you're going to take the first one and you're just going to put it like this, okay? And then I could have just left that one and written things under it, but I'm not going to do that. Okay, so now I'm going to take this second one right here and I'm just going to line up everything with it. So the 8x squared, the first part, is going to go here underneath the 2x squared, right? Because they're like terms. The x squares are the same. Then I'm going to take the minus 5xy and put it under this one. And last is, hold on. We got something wrong here. So see my last one right here? It's not wrong. It says 3y. I cannot put it here because these variables are not the same. So instead of putting it there, I'm going to push it over to right here because it's by itself. There's no other like term with it. Now I'm going to take my last one and I'm going to put it on the last line. So I'm going to have x squared plus 2y squared. Now do you see how I lined them up together? I lined up all of the like terms so that now I can go through and just add everything up. So now I want you to hit pause and I want you to line these up. I mean, not line them up. I want you to add them. So go ahead and hit pause and add them now and then come back and hit play. Okay, so now that you're back, we're going to add these up. Now, when you're adding right here, this 2, 8, and it looks like nothing, right? But that is something. If nothing is there, then it is a 1, right? So we have 2 plus 8 plus 1, so I have 11x squared. Then the next one is, that's a plus 3xy and a minus 5xy. So that's a minus 2xy. Then I have a 7y squared, and that 3y is just hanging out by itself, so it's at the end. So there's my answer. I just added those up, okay? Okay, so pretty simple. So now I'm going to have you do another one, like what I just did, okay, what we just did together. And you're going to have to line them up. So you're going to do everything on your own this time. So here's the problem, 3x squared plus 2x minus 5, and we're going to add to that 8x squared minus 7x minus 10. Make sure that you add up the like terms, the ones that are the same, add those up. Okay, so put them one on top of the other. Or you could just try to do it in your head if you think you can get that done. Okay, so hit pause and go ahead and solve that. Okay, now that you're back, some of y'all might have just said, hey, I know that this 3x and this 8x go together, and you can do it that way. I'm not going to do it that way for notes' sake because I want everybody to see what I'm doing instead of just showing y'all or telling y'all in my head. So I'm going to just leave this one here, and I'm going to line up underneath it. So 8x squared minus 7x minus 10. Make sure that when you're putting these, you don't just put them in order, that you make sure that they are underneath their like term. So this is going to give me 11x squared minus 5x minus 15. And that's my answer for example 3. So see, this is pretty easy, not too difficult here. Okay, so let's do example 4. And this time, you're going to do it on your own. But this time, I'm not going to line them up like this when I show you how to do it. I'm just going to combine them one at a time. Okay, so you can do it that way also. Okay, so this one's going to be 15a squared minus 7ab plus 3c squared minus 12b plus 8ab plus 12c squared minus 3b. Okay, get that all written down. Hit pause and solve that adding polynomial. So you're adding two different terms, not more than two terms, two polynomials, and then come back and see if you got them right. Okay, now that we're back, I'm going to do this one a different way. Instead of writing them on top of each other, I'm going to go through and just find their like terms. So here's 15a squared. This is the part that tells you if it's a like term. So are there any other a squares in this section? There are not. So I'm just going to bring that one down and put 15a squared. So now that was done, I'm just crossing it out so that it helps me see it visually. Okay, now I have minus 7ab. And over here I have 8ab. So notice that that last part is exactly the same. It has to be exactly the same. Even the exponents have to be the same. So when I add those two together, I get 1ab. Do I have to put that 1 there? No, that does not have to be there. So I'm just going to erase it. It just has to say ab. If you put the 1 there, it's okay. It's not going to be counted off. Okay, so now I'm going to cross those two out because I've already got those. And now I'm going to go to the next one, 3c squared. Well, I have a 12c squared over here, so I'm going to put those together. And that gives me 15c squared. Now those are gone. And my last one is the minus 12b and the minus 3b. That's going to give me minus 15b. And there's my answer. Okay, and that's all we need to do. You're just adding like terms. Okay, I hope y'all all got that one correct. Now let's do the very last one I have. Okay, let me write that down. Example 5. Sorry, I was just looking at it to see if there was anything I needed to tell y'all before I did this. Okay, so we have negative 5x plus 3xy plus 7y plus 9. And then we're going to add 5x squared plus 3xy plus 8y squared. Remember, you can hit pause at any time so that you can make it, you can see what I'm writing and take your time writing it on your paper. And then at the very end, I just put a plus 10. It could be in parentheses. That just means there's going to be three of those. So if you're stacking them on top of each other, that 10 would be in the third row, right? Okay, so hit pause and put your like terms together and give me an answer. Okay, hopefully you're back now. You've hit play again. And now let's put these, let's add these together. Okay, so I have x right here, right? So are there any other with just x? No, so that's just going to be negative 5x. Now that one's gone. This one has xy, and I see another xy right there. So that's going to be plus 6xy. And now those are gone. Here's just a y, so I have plus 7y. Right, no other y's, right? And then right here I have 9. My other constant is over here, 10, so that's plus 19. Now notice I haven't crossed everything out. I still have two more. Well, this is an x squared, and there's no other x squared. That one's gone. And this one is a y squared, and it's all by itself. So the point to showing you this one is that they want you to arrange it in order of exponents. So the way that we would arrange this in order is we would take the highest exponent, which is the x squared, okay, and in alphabetical order, so the x squared comes before the y squared. And I'm going to write that one down, and then I would do, the next one would be x, okay? And then I would do the xy because it still has an x in it. So now I've done all my x's, and then I'm going to go through my y's. And the way I'm going to do that is now I'm going to go the opposite direction because this one only had a exponent of a 1, right, that you don't see. So I'm going to go ahead and do the 7y next and then the 8y squared. And always at the end is your constants. Those should never be in the middle. They should always be on the end. So see how I started with an xy and did all my x's. And then since y was in this one, then I kind of went up with the y's. And I had to y squared. And always at the end are the ones with no variables, which are constants. Now, I'm not going to take off if you don't have them in the right order. But it is easier for me to grade where I don't lose one of yours. And if you're looking in the back of the book for an answer, it's going to show you this answer. So if you got this one, so it's all out of order, you're just going to have to go through and see if it's the same ones, if that makes sense. Okay, that's it for today. And then the next lesson will be on subtracting, and we'll talk about that when we get there.